الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له، ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ألف لام ميم، ذلك الكتاب لا ريب فيه هدى للمتقين الذين يؤمنون بالغيب ويقيمون الصلاة ومما رزقناهم ينفقون. صدق الله العظيم. سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. سبحان ربك رب العزة أما يصفون، وسلام على المرسلين، والحمد لله رب العالمين. درود شريف الله سيدنا ونبينا وعلى محمد وعلى آله. All praises belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our creator, our cherisher, the merciful one, the gracious one, the Lord of Adam alayhi salatu wa salam, the Lord of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wa salam, the Lord of Musa alayhi salatu wa salam, the Lord of Isa alayhi salatu wa salam, the Lord of Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Peace, greetings, salutations be upon Sayyidul Awwaleen wal Akhireen, Muhammad Mustafa, Muhammad Mustaba sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Respected brothers, respected elders, mothers and sisters listening at home, the two most important functions inside the heart of a believer, the two most important functions inside the heart of a believer are the qualities of fear and hope. The two most important functions in the heart of a believer are two qualities, hope and fear. Hope in the Urdu language is translated as Umeed ka rakhna, Allah par bharosa hona. Khauf is translated in the Urdu language as Allah ka dar hona, Allah ka khauf hona. Fear. Hope and fear, these two functions are very, very important. These two control the level of iman inside a believer. If there is imbalance in fear and hope, الرَّجَى وَالْخَوْفِ, then the iman gets very, very weak. In fact, the ulama say that iman becomes exposed to shaitan, and there is a possibility that that person can deviate from the straight path and everything will malfunction inside him. Ulama have said, الْإِيمَانُ بَيْنَ الْخَوْفِ وَالْرَّجَى. Iman floats between khawf, fear, and ar-raja, umid ka hona, to have hope. It floats between the two. When we look into the ahadith and into the Quran, the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is given many names. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has been titled with many, many names. The two names are given to him and also mentioned in the Quran. And the two go together in the Quran, like Salah and Zakah. The two go together generally in the Quran. Both names belong to Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the names are Bashir and Nazir. Bashir and Nazir. Who is Bashir and who is Nazir in the Quran? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The translation of Bashir means the one who came in this world to give the good news, glad tidings to those who obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will bless them with Jannah. He is also Nazir at the same time, warning the people that if you disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and if you turn your face away from the ahkam, from the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will punish you severely in the fire of hell, Jahannam. You have Jannat and you have Jahannam. Insha'Allah ta'ala, today, my respected brothers, I wish to talk to you about the condition of the heart. Zara hum apna zati muhasaba kare ki hamari haisiyat kya hai, hum hai kaun. Subhanallah. And that is why I want the brothers to follow me. And it's very, very important. Some of the terms that I use, the Arabic terminology, Islamic terminology, the Arabi mein muhavra hai, usko aap sunay. Bashir and Nazir. Ar-Raja wal-Khawf. To have the fear of Allah and to have hope in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is Bashir. He came to give glad tidings and that he came to warn the people. Hamare ulama ne farmaya hai, mashayikh ne, ke jab insaan ke dil mein Allah ka khauf na ho, to phir nasihat uske dil mein nahi utarti. Gaur se sunay. Jab insaan ke dil mein Allah ka khauf na ho, to phir agar Jibreel alayhi salatu wa salam bhi masjid e Umar ke minbar par baith jaye aur taqreer kare, phir bhi koi fayda nahi. And the dalil of that is in the verse of the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, سَيَذَّكَّرُ مَنْ يَخْشَى. O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, only those people will take heed and advice from you who have the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Jo Allah se darta hi nahi, to phir wo tumhari baat kya lega. And that is why for some people sitting in the bayan is the most difficult task. That is what Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said in the hadith, that for some people the level of iman is so low that when they come and sit in the masjid, they feel that they are imprisoned like a bird in a cage. The minute you open the door of that cage, it wants to fly out. Kab mauka mile, bahana mile, hum bahir nikal jaye. And the believers, the mu'mineen, the muqarrabeen, their condition of iman is such like fish in the water. Fish in the water. Machli ko pani mein hi sukoon milta hai. Mu'min ko Allah ki ghar mein hi sukoon milta hai. So let us see, have we got that right dose, of fear, khauf inside us. Khauf to har insan ke dil mein hota hai. Lekin, kitna khauf hai? Is it the right dose that is needed for iman to float between khauf and raja, between hope and fear? Imam Hassan al-Basri rahmatullah alayh would go around in different localities and he would lecture. Ab waaz farmate. One particular locality he would go frequently. After a few months, some of the people in the gathering said to him, Hazrat, when you speak to us, when you sit on the minbar, and when you lecture us, your words don't affect us. Ye kaun hai? Hazrat Hasan al-Basri. Your words don't affect us. There is no impact in the heart when you speak. Imam Hassan al-Basri rahmatullah alayh looked at them and said, the truth is, don't say to me that there is weakness in your heart. Say to me that your hearts are dead. Mujhe yun kaho ki tumhare dil murde ho chuke. Hamare dil murde ho chuke hai, yun kaho. Why? Because when a person is sleeping, you shake him once, twice, three times, four times, After shaking him up, he will wake up. That when someone is dead, jo aadmi mar gaya ho, no matter how much you shake him, he will not wake up. For the condition of your heart is that your hearts are dead. Tumhare dil murda ho chuke hain, isliye tumhare dil mein koi baat ucharti hi nahi. That is why, my respected brothers and elders, listen attentively. Insha'Allah ta'ala. When we look at the ahadith of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the ulama have divided the ahadith into two categories also. It's all about twos today. وَلِمَنْ خَافَ مَقَامَ رَبِّهِ جَنَّتَانِ وَلِمَنْ خَافَ مَقَامَ رَبِّهِ جَنَّتَانِ فَبِأَيِّ آلَاءِ رَبِّكُمَا تُكَذِّبَانِ. And for the one who fears Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah says for him is two jannat, not one jannat. Jannatani, uske liye do jannat. Ummeed bhi hai, khauf bhi hai, uske liye do jannat. Ek jannat nahi, aaj do do ki baat aap sunen. Khauf aur ummeed, hope and fear, bashir and nazir. And the words of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam are divided into two categories. The hadith might fall under the category of being a targheeb, or it might be a tarheeb. Targheeb or tarheeb. These are words used in the Urdu language also, but originally they are Arabic words. Arabic alfaz. Targheeb or tarheeb. And targheeb means that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has given incentive, hope, aspiration. Insan umeed rakhe that what he does in this dunya, insha'Allah ta'ala, Allah will reward him. And tarheeb means that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has also warned him in the hadith that if you disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the case of nazir, the same thing, nazir and tarheeb, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will punish you. So it is either a hadith which is of targheeb that shows you Jannah, and it is a hadith that warns you of Jahannam, it is targheeb. Subhanallah, Allah give jazai khair to our ulama. They have explained to us when these conditions should apply to us as individuals. When should fear dominate hope, and when should hope dominate fear? Khaufe khuda kab galib hona chahiye, aur phir ummeed khauf par kab galib honi chahiye? The ulama have mentioned when someone is young, strong, when he is healthy and wealthy, and when his beauty and charm stimulates him, he feels that he is something. Young, jawani uske andar hai. When he is young, healthy and wealthy, that is the time the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala should dominate the quality of hope. The quality of hope. The fear should dominate hope. And when a person becomes old, the burhapa aa jaye, weak, frail, kuch yaad nahi rehta, senile, dimag kamzor ho jaye, at that time, hope should dominate fear. Hope should dominate fear. Uski wajah ye hai, when a person is young, he's fast, very quick, the bones are strong, he's got health, he's got wealth, he's got everything, he is exposed to the shaitan. If it is just hope, umeed, 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 Allah ghafoorul raheem hai, Allah ghafoorul raheem hai, and he forgets that Allah is shadeedul iqab, and he forgets jahannam, then it is an easy catch for the shaitan. So the dominant factor should be fear over hope. خوف خدا غالب ہونا چاہیے اس کے اوپر جوانی کی حالت میں تاکہ وہ انسان گناہ سے بچ جائے. بات سمجھ میں آئی ہے نا؟ And when a person is old, he can't maneuver so quickly, he's weak. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, subhanallah, his qudrat is such that that person becomes slightly, the bone structure becomes a bit bent. Aadmi ke andar zara jhukav aa jata hai, jaise koi ruku mein hai. Insaan ko Allah rabbul alameen kamzor kar dete hai. At that time he must have umeed that Allah Rabbul Alameen is Ghafoorul Raheem. Allah will forgive me. At that time if he has fear, then he will become despondent from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Na umeed ho jayega, aur na umeed ye achhi sifat nahi hai us waqt burhape mein. But unfortunately what happens to us today, my respected brothers and elders, that level of khawf, fear of Allah is not in our heart. We come to the masjid, to the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Alhamdulillah, the level of iman is very high. The minute we come out from the masjid, the first thing the eyes do is fornicate. Allah ke ghar mein Allah Allah humne kiya, masjid se bahir nikle to aankhon ne pehla kaam zina ka kiya. We are in the masjid. Let us understand our condition, our heart. Hamari dil ki gehrai ko hum dekhe. Khauf kitna hai? Hum khauf sunte rehte. Kya hai khauf? Sune. We come to the masjid. Alhamdulillah. We are vigilant and alert and conscious that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching us. The minute we step outside, the first thing the eyes does is zina. We are in the masjid, we recite the Quran, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. We follow the recitation of the Quran with ghibat, with backbiting and lying. In fact, in some cases the Quran is open up in front of him. And somebody will come and even very casually without realizing, he will do ghibat of someone. Whilst the Quran is open in front of him, he will backbite. Ah, ji, fala admi to aisa hai. Fala admi aisa ghibat kar raha hai. Al-ghibatu wa shaddu min az-zina. It is worse than zina. And for our mothers and sisters listening at home, we have our mothers and sisters, they are so regular in the Ishraq Salah, never mind Fajr Salah, so regular in the Chash Salah, and the Awabeen and the Nawafil and the Tahajjud, but yet when they go out they unveil their faces and they chit chat very casually with strange men. Funny kisan dukan mein jayegi to dukan wale ke sath, oh ji kaise ho ji, ha how are you, how is everything, itminan ke sath gair maharin ke sath gappe shappe, halanki ishraq ki namaz par nahi, tahajjud ki namaz ke liye wo aurat uthti hai. Look at the condition of the heart, my respected brothers and elders. Is that the desired iman? Is that the iman Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is looking for? Is that the khawf? Is that the level of khawf that should be inside us? Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has mentioned in the hadith, Allahumma inna nas'aluka min khashyatika ma tahulu bihi baynana wa bayna ma'asiyatik. O Allah, I ask from you, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is making a dua. O Allah, I ask from you, Ya Allah, grant me fear, khawf, your fear that will stop me from committing sins, that will prevent me from even getting close to sins. Yani khawf itni badi ni'mat hai Allah Rabbul Alameen. That is why in the Quran Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned, qala rajulani min alladhina yakhafun, that two men spoke out who had the khawf, the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said that the fear is a gift, an'ama Allahu alayhim, this was a gift that Allah gave them.
یہ اللہ کا خوف یہ ایک نعمت ہے it is a gift that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives an individual And if you want to know that you have khawf of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala inside you, it should stop you from sin. Agar Allah ka itna istihzar ho, Allah is watching me, and that person will stop straight away from sins. If he can do that, alhamdulillah, that is the right dose of khawf inside the heart. Ye matlab hai. اسی لئے اللہ رب العالمین نے قرآن کریم میں ارشاد فرمایا انما یخش اللہ من عباده العلماء those who fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are the علماء, the scholars those who have the deep understanding of the Quran and those who have the understanding of the ahadith these are the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala انما یخش اللہ من عباده العلماء سبحان اللہ العظیم Look at our aslaf, predecessors, my respected brothers. Sayyidina Umar Farooq radiallahu ta'ala an, subhanallah, his iman was the result of the personal dua that Nabiya Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made and took his name. And Huzur alayhi salatu wa salam said, Allahumma aizza al-Islam bi Umar ibn al-Khattab. A man of great respect. Once the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to the companions that the good deeds of Umar Farooq are equivalent to the stars in the heavens. The good deeds, the a'mal of Umar Farooq are equivalent to the stars in the heavens. When he would walk in the streets of Madinatul Munawwara, the companions knew that this street is free from shaitan. When you look into the seerah, into the biography of Sayyidina Umar Farooq radiallahu ta'ala and how he physically looked, my respected brothers, it is said that Hazrat Umar Farooq radiallahu ta'ala after embracing Islam, his condition was such that he would cry profusely, tears would flow out from him continuously, that the tears had left a permanent mark on his face. There were marks on the face from the eyes to the cheeks. نیچے تک لکیر تھی چہرے کے اوپر. آنسوں کی وجہ سے. That is how he would cry. The fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala how many times have we heard this in Hikayat-e-Sahaba the Ta'aleem that takes place? He would say, I wish I was just a bird that would fly and one day just die. Ki Allah ke saamne meri peshi hi nahi hoti. Allahu Akbar. Hazrat Uthman would cry so much. The companions would come to him and they would say, why do you weep and cry so much? He would say that, I fear that one day Uthman will have to stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Which Uthman, who was blessed with the two daughters of Nabiya Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to him, Uthman, if I had 40 daughters, one by one, I would give them in your nikah. Kitne razi thay Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Hazrat Uthman ke saath, lekin khashiyat ilahi kitni thi. Khauf khuda kitna tha. Allahu Akbar kabira. Imamul Anbiya, Sayyidul Awwaleen wal Akhireen, محمد مصطفی مجتبی صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم my respected brothers when the companions noticed that he had grey hair white hair in the beard they came running to him یہ تو عاشق رسول تھے انہوں نے کہا اللہ کے رسول آپ تو برہے ہو چکے ہیں oh prophet of Allah you have aged حالانکہ حضور علیہ السلام کی اتنی کوئی خاص عمر نہیں تھی you have aged The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to the companions, it is the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that has made me grow old. Yeh burhapa sufed baal jo tum dekh rahe ho daari mein, yeh khashiyat-e-ilahi. Shayibatni hood, the verses of the Quran have made me old. The manazir, the events of the hereafter, what will happen on the day of qiyamah. There was one janazah, a janazah of a baby. in front of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made dua for that child. Allah save this baby from the punishment of the grave. Allah save this baby from the fire of Jahannam. Allah save him in the grave. Allah save him from the fire of Jahannam. The companions were shocked. Pucha Allah ke Rasul, ye to masoom bachcha hai. Baby, bil-akhir, azab-e-qabr is bachche ke upar, Jahannam ki aag is bachche ke liye. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam looked at the companions and said, don't get too complacent with your iman because you say, La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. Don't get too complacent. Bahut mutmain na ho jao tum apne kalma ke upar, kalme ke upar. There is no guarantee of Jannah until Allah gives the guarantee. There is no guarantee of Jannah until Allah gives the guarantee. Meri aur aapki kya haisiyat hai dosto aur buzurgo? Hamare gharon mein aisi aisi cheeze hain ke jo Allah ki rahmat ke darwaze ko band kar deti hai. Kya haal hoga hamara? Ulama have even explained to us that the category of khawf, fear of Allah, in individuals is very different. Each individual, his fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is different to the person in front of him. Har insan ka iman aur har insan ka khawf juda hota hai ek dusre se. For the general public, their fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is like the fear of a child of his father. The child fears the father that if I disobey him, my father will strike me, punish me, marenge abba. Aap na marna, varna child abuse ho jayega. Aap na marna, varna kya ho jayega? Child abuse ho jayega. So some people fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because of Jahannam, that Allah will punish them with the fire. And those who are the muqarrabeen, the level of iman, the elite, the quality iman, the elite people, the muqarrabeen, ulama, sulaha, awliyaullah, their fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is like the fear of the wife as compared to the husband. The fear that wife has for the husband. The wife does not fear that if I disobey my husband, the husband will beat me up. Especially not in this country. Aisa to nahi hai na ki aap ghar jaakar auton ko maarte hai. Alhamdulillah, aisa nahi karna chahiye. The wife does not fear, like what that child fears, that my father will strike me, hit me straight away. The wife does not fear that. An intelligent woman, aur jo masturat ghar par sun rahi hai, zara gaur se sune. An intelligent woman is that woman who knows that if I disobey my husband, his love for me will decrease. His love for me will decrease. And I can't afford that. Hushyar aurat wo hoti hai. Huququllah ke baad. Uska sabak yehi hai ke wo apne miyaan ke saath. ایسا رشتہ رکھے کہ میاں کی محبت اس کے لیے بڑھتی ہی رہے بڑھتی ہی رہے. فَذَا أَوْلِيَا اللَّهُ صُلَحَا they fear with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is like that. That they don't want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to become ناراض from them, کہ اللہ ناراض نہ ہو جائے. جہنم کا خوف نہیں, اللہ کی ناراضگی کا خوف. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not become displeased with them. اللہ کی ناراضگی نہ ہو ان کے اوپر. یہ اصل چیز ہے میرے دوستو اور بزرگو. علامہ ابن القیم الجوزی رحمت اللہ علیہ, a great scholar, he says that don't divide and categorize the sins into two parts, major and minor sins. Don't rank the sins. Think that when you commit a sin, you are disobeying that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the majestic one. Allah who is Khalik, Allah who is Ghafoor. Look at Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. his position, his might, his glory, can you even afford for a second to disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? You na dekho ke gunah hai sagira kya hai, gunah hai kabira kya hai, apni tawajjuh Allah ki taraf. Allah ki taraf ho to insaan kamyab ho jata hai. Subhanallah al-azim. My respected brothers, someone in the family, take for an example a child. When he disobeys the father once, twice, three times, four times, continuously disobeying the father, a time comes when the father says to the child that I am warning you now for the last time. If you misbehave now, I will throw you out of the house. Wo apni sagi aulad ki qurbani dene ke liye tayyar ho jata. I will throw you out of the house. I am fed up of you. My respected brothers and elders, in our 24 hours that Allah has given us, 100 times, 200 times, 300 times, 500 times we disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Lekin kabhi bhi Allah rabbul alameen ne mere aur aapke liye masjid ka darwaza band nahi kiya. That person can't come because he has disobeyed me. That person can't come because he hasn't prayed his fajr salah. That person can't come because he has done that guna. This person can't come because he has done gunahe kabira. No. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the merciful one, has left the doors open. Come. In the Quran we have one other word, my respected brothers, which is huzn. Kya hai? Huzn. Thodi der aap sunte rahe dost aur buzurgon. Like khauf, raja. Another word in the Quran is huzn. Huzn in the Urdu language can be translated as gham. Gham. Ulama have mentioned that when somebody suffers from huzn, then what he does is that he stops eating. What does he do? He stops eating. Khana uska band ho jata hai. Matlab ye hai ki khuraak bahut kam andar jati hai. Agar kha bhi le to koi zaika nahi. If he suffers from huzn, he stops eating. Inner anxiety. Andaruni pareshan, dil ke andar, huzn. And let me give you an example, so it becomes easy for the brothers to understand. Allah forbid, huzn, an example. Allah forbid that the husband dies, and there was this good relationship between husband and wife for many years. 30-40 saal ka rishta ho. Achanak, husband, bilkul tandurust tha, and he suffered a heart attack and he has died. It was a shock for the wife. Even after a month, you put in front of her the best food. Dastarkhan sajaye, behtareen se behtareen khana aap wahan rakhe. And you say to her, eat, she will say to you, there is no zaika, there is no maza in eating. Lutfi nahi hai, kyun? Gham, huzn, this is huzn. If a mother loses a child, Allah meri aapki hifazat farmaye, 16-17 saal ka bachcha, 16-17 year old child, all of a sudden, accident, bachche ka intikal ho gaya, and you break this information to the mother, even after 1 year you put in front of her quality food, you take her out, you take her everywhere, the food becomes tasteless. Zaika hi nahi hai uska. Isko kehte hai huzn. Ulama have mentioned like how in the case of huzn, a person stops eating. When Allah blesses someone with khawf, he stops sinning. He stops sinning. Jaise huzn se khane ka zaika, khana ban ho jata hai. Hakikat mein jis insaan ke dil mein Allah ka khawf hota hai, تو وہ گناہ سے محفوظ ہو جاتا ہے. گناہ سے محفوظ ہو جاتا ہے. صحابہ اکرام اجمعین, read the تاریخ. The disbelievers did not know how to break the unity of the Muslims and the taqwa they had. And what they did, that they put prostitutes on the road when they knew that the companions were going to pass from this road. And aliyazu billah, nude, semi-nude women were there. اور گندی گندی عورتیں, یہ تاریخ اور سیرت کی کتابوں میں موجود ہے. As I say, the only way to break the companions is this way, that we involve them in the fitna of women. Khuda ki qasam, dost aur buzurgon, not a single sahabi glanced at that lady. Ye khaufi khuda tha. And that is why, when they would lift up their hands, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's nusrat would come. Hazrat Umar Farooq would be in Madinatul Munawwara. And information would come to him, that country has been conquered, that country is now Darul Islam, that country is Darul Islam, that country is Darul Islam. Why? The right dose of khauf. Khauf was there. Khauf to har ek ke dil mein hota hai. Allah ka khauf to hota hai. Aapko doctor ne ek dawai di, dosto aur buzurgo. And doctor ne kaha ki aapne itni dawai peeni hai. Aur aap itni thori si dawai peete hai. Doctor ko kahe, doctor sahab, aap hi galat hai. Doctor kahe tumhe ki bhai tumne dawai kitni li. Jo dose tumhe diya, itni dawai leni chahiye tumhare andar asar karne ke liye. To phir doctor ka kya kasoor? So the right dose of khauf has to be inside us, my respected brothers. And this, the month of Ramadan is for that. Soul searching. Hum apni zaat ko dekhe. Hum kaise hain? Subhanallah al-Azim. One young man came to his sheikh, buzrug, ek alim ke jin ke saath unka taalluk tha. A young man. Handsome man. And he came to this buzrug and he said, Hazrat, he would visit him regularly and said, I am very weak. I have this weakness inside me. Hazrat sitting in front of him said, what is your weakness? Aisi kaun si kamzori hai tumhare andar? He said, Hazrat, I have this habit that I look at women. My eyes have this habit that they glance very quickly at women and pray at women. And I peep at women. Jahan ho sake masturat ko main dekh leta hoon. جاؤں سکے عورتوں کو میں دیکھتا ہوں بد نظری کا شکار. This is my weakness and I can't stop it. Hazrat said, no problem, come to me tomorrow. When he came, the sheikh said to him, look, are you prepared to do anything what I tell you without questioning me? He said, yes, whatever you tell me I will do without questioning you. He said, fine. He said to one of the students, bring me a bowl, ek piala, and Hazrat fill that bowl with milk اور اس پیالے کو دودھ سے بھر کر خوب لبریز کر دیا. Filled it up to the top. Right to the top. And Hazrat said to this young man that I have a family member who lives on the other side of the town. What I want you to do is to take this bowl of milk to the other side of the town to my friend and make sure that when you take this bowl which has milk inside, not a single drop of milk must spill. Doodh ka ek katra bhi girna nahi chahiye. Baat samajh mein aayi ya nahi? And Hazrat said, no questioning, no questioning. He says, one more thing. Oh, Hazrat thay aise, ek pehlwan ko bulaya, mashallah, very muscular and strong. Kaha tum idhar aao? And Hazrat gave him a stick, danda uske haath mein. Kaha, look, I want you to accompany this young boy and go with him all the way to the other side of the town until this bowl of milk is delivered to that person, and stay behind him and be alert. Every time a single drop of milk spills, usko joote se marna, tamacha marna, lakri se marna, saryam marna. Hit him, strike him, slap him. Put the bowl down and hit him in front of people. Now this young man heard everything. Andaza kare. Ab usne haan to keh diya Hazrat ko. He took up the challenge. He picked up that bowl. And he walked slowly and slowly. He had no choice but to cut through the bazaar. The person was living in such an area that he had to go through the bazaar. And very slowly, 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 he goes and that person with the stick is behind him looking, making sure. Dekh raha hai ki kuch gir na jaye. And alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah, he is successful, mission accomplished. He goes all the way there without spilling anything. And he comes back. Aur wo farishta jo peeche tha, wo bhi saath aaya. And he came to Hazrat and said, Hazrat, alhamdulillah, what you told me I have done. Hazrat said, never mind that. Never mind that. Tell me, did you see my friend in the shop
did you see that person in that shop? He said, no. He said, did you see falan, that person in that shop? He said, no. Did you see that person in that other shop? Kapre ki dukaan mein wo aadmi mera dost tha, usko dekha kahin na? Kaha tum bazaar se gaye, kisi ko nahi dekha. You did not see no one. Say, Hazrat, no, I did not see anyone. My eyes were glued to the milk. I was scared that that Pathan, that person, that strong man who is behind me, who's got a stick, is going to whip me and hit me. So I was alert that not a single drop of milk should spill. Mujhe to ye khatra tha ki ye aadmi peeche mazboot aadmi mujhe marega. And so my eyes were glued. They did not wander and venture off to all the shops in the bazaar. Hazrat said that you are scared of one human being and you are scared of the stick that he is holding and you are scared that he will hit you and you don't want to disobey me. You were so vigilant carrying that bowl of milk. And Hazrat said to that young boy, my son, your heart is also a bowl. Your heart is also a bowl. And milk is iman that is inside your heart. Have the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Allah, Rahman, Rahim, Ghafoorur Rahim is watching you. This should stop you. And if your heart is under control, your eyes will be under control. If your heart is under control, tumhara dil pak gaya, to sare aza uske tabe hai. The heart is the king. King ke bagair, Imam Ghazali ki kitab Ihya ul-Ulumuddin ko aap pare, kuch nahi hota dil ke bagair. Hamara dil nahi bana hai, isliye fir aankh hi nahi bani, kaan bhi nahi bane, zuban bhi nahi bani, dil nahi bana. Aur dil ke andar wo khashiyat nahi hai, wo khauf nahi hai. That right level of fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not there. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the tawfiq, my respected brothers. It is easy. In fact, my respected brothers, main aapko itni baat keh doon ke basa aukaat shaitan itna dhoka deta hai. The maestro of all evil, he cheats people. And in fact, in some cases, I'm not accusing anybody. In some cases, if someone cries, it is even crocodile tears. Wo aansu bhi galat aansu hai. Galat aansu. Quran Kareem mein uski daleel milti hai. Farmaya Surah Yusuf mein, وَجَاءُوا أَبَاهُمْ عِشَاءً يَبْكُونَ. And the brothers of Yusuf alayhi salatu was salam came to Yaqub alayhi salam. What were they doing? What were the brothers doing? Crying. The Quran says, Yabkoon. They were crying. Lekin ye aansu, galat aansu the unke. Ikhlas ke saath wo qatre nahi nikle the. Un aansuon mein dhoka tha. The tears were not right. It did not have sincerity. Khaufe khuda ghalib nahi tha. Ulama have mentioned that for a God-fearing person living in this dunya, he fears two things the most. He fears two things the most. God se sune dosto aur buzurgo, inshallah. Ramadan ka mubarak mahina hai. Aur ek baat ye bhi arz kar do, please brothers. I hope everybody realizes that it is not the end of Ramadan. Sahi hai na? Baaz log yun na samjhe ke khatm-e-Quran ho gaya to sab kuch ho gaya. Please come for Taraweeh tomorrow. There is a possibility that Laylatul Qadr can also be tomorrow or the day after. So please come for Taraweeh. Don't let the shaitan deceive us. Nafs hamare upar hamla karta hai. Ji, mashallah, alam taraf se qiraat ho gayi, everything is over. We feel very light in the heart. Now we are just waiting for Eid. Eid ul Fitr. What time is Eid? 9:30. What time is Bayan? 9 o'clock. What is Sadqah Fitr? £1.50. We are already prepared now for Eid. Allahu Akbar, make preparations for Eid, no problem. Subhanallah. But we still have the blessed days. Varna to aitikaf mautakifin ki aadhi chutti ho jati. Chutti hoti hai? Nahi. Chutti nahi hoti. Inka aitikaf toot jayega. Two things a God-fearing person fears in this dunya the most. The first thing, my respected brothers, the greatest fear of a believer, of a mu'min, is that he must fear that at the time of death, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not take away from him iman. This must be the greatest fear. Sabse zyada khauf is baat ka hona chahiye ki maut ke waqt ایسا نہ ہو کہ اس کا ایمان ہی چلا جائے.
This should be the greatest fear. Why in the hadith of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam it is mentioned, my respected brothers, that when a person breathes his last, سکرات کا وقت ہوتا ہے, and now he is in the middle of this dunya and عالم برزخ, it is time of سکرات, it is said that the shayateen come to him, and they come to him in the form of those relatives that have passed away. Those relatives that have passed away. غور سے سنیں, رشتے داروں کی شکل میں شیاطین آتے ہیں. اندازہ کریں ہم کتنے کمزور ہیں اس وقت. اللہ ہی جانے دوستو اور بزرگو کہ ہماری روح کہاں نکلے گی, گھر میں نکلے گی, ہسپتال میں نکلے گی, کہاں نکلے گی. ایسی حالت میں شیاطین آتے ہیں, and they come in the face of their dead relatives, and they say, oh my child, oh my son, don't waste your time. These people that are doing talqeen in front of you saying la ilaha illallah, don't believe them. Look, we have already been there. We died 20 years before you. We died 40 years before you. Hum tumhare dada hote hain, hum tumhari dadi hote, nana nani hai, rishtedar hai, chacha hote hain. I am your father, I am your mother, we have passed away. Don't believe the alim that is standing here, that is saying, say la ilaha illallah. Don't believe them. Believe me what I say to you. I have already seen that part of the world. There is no Allah. Al-iyazu billah. There is no Allah. Don't say la ilaha illallah. You are wasting your time. Nothing will happen. You die, that is it. کیسا امتحان ہوگا دوستو اور بزرگو, ذرا غور کرے آپ. میرا آپ کا امتحان ابھی کیا ہے؟ جو امتحان آ رہا ہے وہ اصل ہے. ہمارے اکابرین کیوں روتے تھے؟ حضرت سفیان رضی اللہ تعالی عنہ was crying. Some of the companions came to him and they said, حضرت, why are you crying? He said, I fear of standing in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Some of the companions said, oh great sahabi of Rasulullah, is it because you have committed sins that you are crying? And he smiled. And there was a mustard seed in front of Hazrat Sufyan radiallahu ta'ala an. He picked up that mustard seed, wo dana chota sa, and he showed the companions. He was a sahabi himself. He said, I have not disobeyed Allah equivalent to this mustard seed also. Kaisi latafat hogi, kaisi paak roo hogi, کیسا پاک نفس ہوگا. خود یوں کہے کہ میں نے اللہ کی نافرمانی اتنی نہیں کی. Then why do you fear and cry so much? And he says that I fear that I don't know what will be my state, what will be my condition at the time when Malakul Maut comes to me. میری روح کو جب نکالا جائے گا تو اس وقت میری کیا حالت ہوگی, ایمان سالم ہوگا یا نہیں. When Shaitan will come in the face of family members and will say, don't worry, there is no God. Allahu Akbar, what answer will we give? ہم تو اتنا کمزور ہیں, کوئی ایسی چیز آج دیکھتے ہیں تو غیروں کے ساتھ بھی ہمارا تعلق ہو جاتا ہے, غیروں کے ساتھ. اسی لئے آپ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم نے فرمایا کہ مسیح الدجال کے آنے سے پہلے تم تیاری کر لو, سورة الکہف کو پڑھا کرو تاکہ تمہاری حفاظت ہو. The greatest magician From the time Adam alayhi salatu was salam was created, no magician is like Masih al-Dajjal. Uski tarah jadugar koi aaya nahi hai aur koi aayega nahi. Aisa uska khel hoga, jadu hoga. Bade bade log jinka iman mazboot ho uske samne wo usko kamzor kar dega. Farmaya suratul kahf ko padhte raho. Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal rahmatullah alayhi was breathing his last. Students were in front of him. Who is Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal rahmatullah alayhi? Subhanallah, who has compiled the great Musnad, Musnad Ahmad. One great portion of the Ummah follows him in fiqh, Imam Ahmad. Balki Saudi Arabia ki jo fiqh hai, wo Hanabila hai. Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal ki tarteeb ke upar chalti hai. Jaise hum Hanafi. And he was there breathing his last. The students were there. And they were doing talqeen in front of him. Talqeen karna sunnate rasool hai. آدمی سکرات کے وقت میں آ جائے, آخری گریہ ہو, then one should say لا الہ الا اللہ, لا الہ الا اللہ محمد رسول اللہ, لا الہ الا اللہ محمد رسول اللہ. And when the students were saying in front of him, La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah, Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal opened one eye and looked at them. And he said, La, and turned away. La. And the students came and said, La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal turned away and said, La. And La. Continuously saying La. It was as if though Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal was rejecting the kalima La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. The students got worried. Ye kya majra hai? Ye kya halat hai? Itne bade waqt ke imam. Abhi hosh mein the. He's saying La, La, La. After a bit, when he woke up, he looked at the students and he said, I said La, La, three times. Let me tell you what happened. He said that Shaitan came to me with a glass of water. Gaur se sunay. Shaitan came to me with a glass of water. Sakarat ke waqt pyaas bahut lagti hai. Ye, the throat becomes dry. Aur aisi pyaas lagti hai. Khushk ho jata hai ye gala hamara. And the shaitan said, Ahmad bin Hanbal, if you want water, I will give you water. Here, take this water. He said, but before I give you this glass of water, say, Kul Isa ibnullah. Say, Isa is the son of God. Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal ka ye imtihan ho raha hai, mera aapka kaisa hoga? Sochne ki baat hai, dost aur buzurgon. Sochne ki baat. ہم تو ایمان والے لوگ ہیں ہمارا تو عقیدہ ہے ہم تو ان چیزوں کے اوپر ایمان رکھتے ہیں and the shaitan says قل عیسیٰ ابن اللہ all you say is say Jesus is the son of God Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal turned his face away said لا the first لا was to Iblis the shaitan when I turned my face the shaitan came on the other side and said Imam Ahmad قل عیسیٰ ابن اللہ Say that Isa is the son of God. I will give you this glass of water. Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal turned his face and said, La, no, I can't say that. He came again for the third time. And he said, okay, if you don't say Isa is the son of God, then just say, Kul, La ilaha. Kul, La ilaha. Just say that there is no God. Itna keh do, ke khalik hi nahi hai. Allah hi nahi hai, aliyazu billah. Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal ka wo taqwa tha. اللہ کے ولی تھے ان کی یہ کیفیت تھی کہ وہ تو لا بول سکے میری آپ کی کیا کیفیت ہوگی دوست اور بزرگو امام احمد بن حنبل turned his face again for the third time and said لا and he looked at the students and he said you be my witness لا الہ الا اللہ محمد الرسول اللہ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم and he passed away بڑا خطرے کا موقع ہوتا ہے دوست اور بزرگو وہ آخری گری جو ہوتی ہے 2 weeks ago A lady rang me. She doesn't live in Leicester. So aap phir kisi ko zehen mein na bithaye. Ye galat baat hai. She does not live in Leicester. She rang me. And she said to me, Maulana, I am possibly a Christian. I am possibly a Christian. Yani Musalman ladki, naujawan ladki. I am possibly a Christian. I have already been to the church and the priests are accommodating me very well. They are looking after me. And I get a lot of peace when I'm in the church. Aliyazu billah. Musalman ladki aurat. And partly to blame is also in some cases the parents, the environment. Listening to her, she was saying that my parents were forcing me to marry this person from where the parents were born. Main naam nahi leta, but walidain ki majboori thi ke tumhe shaadi karni hai to us bacche se jo hamare mulk mein wahan. And she said, no, I don't want to marry him. And eventually that led to fights, disturbance in the family. Eventually she left and ran away. When she ran away, aapko to pata hai is mulk mein foreign sahara ye log de dete. She was given accommodation, she was living in a hostel. She was sharing a room with this lady, a young girl. Young lady. And she said to this, she was a Christian, she said to this Muslim girl that why do you panic and why do you fear? Look, this was my condition but now Jesus Christ comes to me every night. Shaitan aata hoga. عیسیٰ علیہ السلام کیا آئیں گے عیسیٰ علیہ السلام آئیں گے تو
خیر مٹ جائے گی تمہاری سارے لوگ مسلمان ہو جائیں گے.
And every day in the night, Jesus comes to me, and that loving Father in the heavens, you know how they talk, the loving Father in the heaven and His blessed Son, Holy Spirit, or sari ye unke jo baatein hoti hai. And said, look, believe in the loving God. Kya kehte hain? Believe in the loving God. Jesus came as a mercy.
Halanki rahmatulil alamin sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ki ye shaan thi.
I said, don't worry, everything will be okay. And this is the time the jinns and the shayateen attack a person when he is vulnerable, when he is weak, when the family members have abandoned him or her. And she is out from that environment, from that Islamic culture. The bahir nikal jaye, us waqt shaitan ka hamla hota hai. And she said to me that she gave me a copy of the Bible. I read it. After reading it, I went to sleep. For the first time, I went to sleep. I was at ease and peace. Bari rahat mujhe mili, main so gayi. Aliyazu billah, and she says that when I was sleeping, all of a sudden, my physical posture, that how one sleeps. Ab zahir hai, aadmi sota hai, so he's in different position. And she says that when I was sleeping, it was as if like I was in that form of a cross. You saw it. لیکن شیطان کیسا انسان کو گمراہ کرتا ہے. اب ایسا سونا یہ سونا کیا سونا. سبحان اللہ, لوگ آ کر کہتے جی ٹماٹو میں اللہ کا نام ہے. ارے بھائی سبحان اللہ, پورا قرآن سینے میں ہے, ٹماٹو کو چھوڑو. اللہ کا نام ٹماٹو میں ہے, میں دیکھا پورا قرآن 5 سال کے بچے کے دل میں ہے, کیا وہ کافی نہیں. سبحان اللہ. Oh, my mom was cutting this vegetable and the name of Allah was there. Maulana, what do we do? I say, bring it to me, I will eat it. Kya baat hai, dosto aur buzurgon. And this lady, and the parents left her. Aapko pata hai, baaz walidain to aise hote hai, chhod dete hai. Very cultural minded people. Ek martaba keh diya, bahir nikal jao, so bahir nikal jao. Phir maut aa jaye, lekin ye bachi ghar mein na aaye. Very cultural people. Hibachi Bahir. Now she is exposed to the Christian community, to the shayateen that are out there, the jinns that are out there. And she reads the Bible, she does not read the Quran. And all of a sudden she says that one day I fell down in my room as if I was unconscious. And I felt somebody walking into my room, someone very handsome with a beard. And it seemed that it was Jesus coming in front of me. And Jesus came down and said to me, oh my child, don't worry, I am here as a savior for you. Aliyazu billah. Maine usko kaha, did you see him? Kano, I felt something like that. Hallucinations. This is the jinn, this is the shaitan, this is how he makes a mockery out of a person who is vulnerable. Subhanallahi lazeem, subhanallahi lazeem. I said, my dear sister, now you listen to me. Bifazlillahi ta'ala, she recited the kalima on the phone and she did tajdeed of her iman. And she said, La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. And I said to her, read the ayatul kursi. She said to me, Walana, when I read the ayatul kursi, I could see darkness coming out from me. Jaise ki wo cheez mere andar se nikal rahi hai. Ayatul kursi ke andar itni taqat hai. Phone ke andar, maine usko kaha, tum kalma karo. کیا بھروسہ. 2 دن پہلے ہی پھر ایک بندے کا فون آیا جو اس کے ساتھ ہے, مسلمان ہے الحمدللہ. میں نے اس کو کہا رمضان میں مشغولی ہے لیکن آپ مجھے فون کرنا. میں نے کہا کیسی ہے وہ بندی؟ کہا الحمدللہ, شی از نارمل بائی دا گریس آف اللہ سبحانہ وتعالیٰ. دین اسلام اس کا کوئی مقابلہ کر سکتا ہے دوستو اور بزرگوں؟ سبحان اللہ العظیم. Somebody was just telling me that in Rochester or پتہ نہیں کون سا علاقہ ہے, there was one English lady that was walking through this alleyway and one man came and astaghfirullah raped her. Ye ghair muslim aurat thi, English lady. To cut the story short, some dino ke baad there was a Muslim lady that walked exactly through that alley, and it just so happens that that person was there and looked at this Muslim lady and wanted to attack her. But he did not succeed. He came close, but he didn't do anything. She went home.
she said to the mother that this is what has happened. The parents were aware that something had already happened in that area. Somebody was raped. They reported that to the police. Eventually the police caught that person. And the police said to that English lady, and that Muslim lady was also there to give witness and their statements. And the police said to that, the perpetrator, that man, that you raped this lady. This lady was also vulnerable all alone. Why didn't you rape her? Kya hua? So this man said that no, she was not alone. She was with two strong men, strong people that were accompanying her. So this lady said that no men were with me. The only thing was that when I was passing through that alleyway, I was reading Ayatul Kursi. I was reading Ayatul Kursi. Ye ghaibi madad hoti hai dost parmi. What will happen to us? Subhanallah al-Azim. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said that for some people throughout their life they engage into good deeds, good acts, good actions. And they are only one span away from Jannah. All of a sudden, Subhanallah al-Azim, they turn away from Jannah and go into Jahannam. One span away from entry into Jannah. Or fir wo jahannam mein dakhil ho jate. And vice versa, some people have disobeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and they are on the track of Jahannam and they are one span away from Jahannam and all of a sudden they enter into Jannah. Subhanallah. Isliye mere dosto aur buzurgon, hum masjid mein aate rehte hain. Alhamdulillah, bahut achhi baat hai. But we should not be complacent. Ye nahi ke ab to hame jannat mil hi gayi. Nahi. سارے مراحل تو ابھی آنے ہیں. خوف خدا کتنا ہے ہمارے اندر. سبحان اللہ العظیم. And the muhaddithin have explained this hadith by the word shibran, one span. What is the meaning of one span? The muhaddithin have said that this is the time of sakarat. At the time of sakarat, he did everything good, but at the time of sakarat, the shaitan came and snatched his iman away. The ulama have mentioned, and they have taken this out from the ahadith, that for three types of people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala snatches the iman away from them at the time of death. Teen kisam ke log. One is a bidati. Kaun? Bidati. Jo bid'at karta hai. Someone who innovates and gives the label of sunnah to something that is not the sunnah. Something that is not the sunnah, you label it to be sunnah. That is innovation. Bidati ka bhi ye hal hota hai. کہ وہ موت کے وقت اللہ ہی بہتر جانتے ہیں اس کے ایمان کی کیا کیفیت ہے. اس لیے دوستو اور بزرگو ایک بات میں آپ کو کہہ دوں, جنت البقیع میں سونے والے متقین ہی ہے. کون ہے؟ متقین ہی. اہل حق ہی ہے, اہل بدت نہیں. اہل بدت متقین ہی ہے. سبحان اللہ. And the second type of people from whom iman is taken away at the time of death are those people who openly humiliate pious people of the ummah of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Jo nek log hote sulaha is ummat ke, unke mutalliq bura bhala kehte. Farmaye Allah aise logo par itne naraz hote hai ki in logo ko iman se mahroom rakh dete. And the third category of people are those people who openly sin, fasik fajir, kisi ka dar nahi. They have the audacity in the month of Ramadan, they eat, they don't have respect and they don't honor any part of Islam. They openly sin. فرمایا ایسے لوگوں کے لیے موت کے وقت بھی بہت سختی ہے. Allah takes away the iman. Subhanallah al-Azim, my respected brothers. Allah پا خاتمہ بالخیر فرمائے. On the day of Qiyamah, there will be some children who will curse their own parents. Curse their own parents. وَقَالُوا رَبَّنَا إِنَّا أَطَعْنَا سَادَتَنَا وَكُبَرَانَا فَأَدَلُّونَ السَّبِيلَ. Oh Allah, we are going to go to Jahannam, we will be punished. But Allah, we have a request, a plea that we make in front of you. We obeyed our father. The father said, my son, I want you to educate yourself, mashallah, have a BA, MA, sare A's and PhD and become a doctor. Don't take me wrong, I'm not saying education is not right. understand me what I'm trying to say. Akal man ke liye ishara kafi hota hai. Subhanallah al-azim.
But he did not show us the door of Iman and Islam. He did not show us the door of madrasa. He did not put in front of us the importance of recitation of the Quran, the importance of taqwa, the importance of salah, the importance of fasting. He did not educate us in Islam. All he wanted was us to become professional people. Allah, we have become professional people. But now we are destined to go to Jahannam. Allah, we have a plea to make. Rabbana, atihim di'afaini min al-azab. Allah, when you punish us, give my father double the punishment what you give us. وَالْعَنْهُمْ لَعْنًا كَبِيرًا. Allah, curse them. Allah, تمہارے, آپکی لانت ہو ہمارے والدین کے اوپر. بیٹا ماں باپ کے اوپر لانتان کرے گا. لعنًا كَبِيرًا, بہت بری لانت. A lady phoned one alim and said that, Mulana, I want to go to university. I want to educate myself. What is the Islamic verdict? Islam kya kehta hai ek aurat ke liye ke jo parna chahe. Mulana sahab said to her that, first tell me what is your intention for going to college and university. Tumhari niyat to pehle dekhe. Niyat sunenge mere dosto aur buzurgon. The girl said to this Mulana, that, oh Maulana sahab, my father said to me, oh my darling daughter, educate yourself and have some qualifications under your belt, so that one day if your husband was to dump you, you are independent and self-sufficient. Hamari niyat mein kitni kharabi hai. So that one day if your husband was to dump you, you are independent. Tum husband ki muhtaj nahi ho. So educate yourself. Maulana ne fatwa de diya, it is not jaiz and haram for you to go and acquire knowledge. Aisi niyat ho. Aisi niyat se tum taaleem haasil karo. Khatima bil khair. Itni bari ni'mat hai suratul baqara. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَوَصَّى بِهَا إِبْرَاهِيمُ بَنِيهِ وَيَعْقُوبُ. Were you present when Ibrahim alayhi salatu was salam and Yaqub alayhi salatu was salam were giving their last advice to their children, the last words, wasiyah. And they said to their children, Nabi saying to the children, Ya baniya, inna Allah astafa lakumu ad-deena, fala tamutunna illa wa antum muslimun. O my children, Allah has given you a beautiful deen. Make sure that the soul does not depart from your body, but only in the condition that you are a Muslim. Nabi ko itni fikr. Quran Kareem ne ek naksha khincha. فرمایا ام کنتم شہداء اذ حضر یعقوب الموت. Were you there present when Yaqub alayhi salatu was salam was breathing his last? ام کنتم شہداء اذ حضر یعقوب الموت. Subhanallah. And he said to the children, ما تعبدون من بعدي. O my children, who will you worship when your father dies, when your father passes away from this dunya? This is the fikr a father had for his children. And the children said, قَالُوا نَعْبُدُوا. Oh, our father, worry not, we guarantee you, inshaAllah ta'ala, نَعْبُدُوا, we will worship إِلَٰهَكَ, your Lord, وَإِلَٰهَ أَبَائِكَ, and the Lord of your father, Ibrahim alayhi salam, Ismail alayhi salam, Ishaq alayhi salam. Ibrahim wa Ismail wa Ishaq, إِلَٰهَ وَاحِدَ, one Lord, one Allah, وَنَحْنُ لَهُ مُسْلِمُونَ. And rest assured, the children said that we are from the Muslimin. Isliye dosto aur buzurgo, Allah ka khauf itna hona chahiye. We must have the right dose of fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that prevents us from sinning. Gunah se hum bach sake. Agar ye sabak hum le le aur khauf ko itna badhaye dil mein, to inshaAllah hum kamyab honge. Bas baat khatam karta hoon dosto aur buzurgo. Everything in the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has got the fear of Allah. Everything. Allah says, وَإِن مِّن شَيْءٍ إِلَّا يُصَبِّحُوا بِحَمْدِهِ وَلَكِنْ لَا تَفْقَهُونَ تَسْبِيحَهُمْ. Everything in the kingdom of Allah does the tasbih of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but you don't have the capacity to understand. Everything in the creation. Allah has created the trees, and the trees are in that erected position, in that standing position, what we know as qiyam. Namaz mein hum qiyam ki halat mein hote hain. This qiyam is the tasbih of the tree.
It worships Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in that posture of standing. اور وہ درخت اللہ کی عبادت میں مشغول قیام ہے. The animals, چوپائے, they are in that posture of ruku, worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continuously, ruku کی حالت میں. Insects are in that posture of sujood, complete prostration to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Subhanallah. And they worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the mountains that Allah has created, sitting on the face of this earth, they are in the position of at-tahiyyat. At-tahiyyat ki position mein baithe huye hai, Allah ki tasbih kar rahe. Dunya ki har cheez Allah ko yaad kar rahi hai. Insan kitna khush naseeb, ke jo saari alag alag ibadat Allah ne dusri makhlukat ko diya, Allah ne un saari cheezon ko tumhari namaz mein jama kar diya. A person does qiyam, ruku, sujood, at-tahiyyat, sits in that position, everything is there. One man came to Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. One man came to Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he put his case forward to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He was a hard worker. He would load his camel with goods in the morning, early in the morning, and take it to the market and sell the goods. And this was his business. And then he would sit on the camel, come back, and in the night he would sleep and rest. There was only one problem. His camel would not let him sleep in the night. The camel would disturb him. Ye log khayme mein sote the, khayma, tent. And the camel is outside. And the camel would make so much noise throughout the night. It would disturb him. He was so tired. He gets tired. He works a busy day for him. Wakes up early in the morning, comes late in the night. He needs a good sleep. And this is what the camel does. So he came to Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, subhanallah, and said, O Prophet of Allah, this is my camel. I fulfill all my rights for this camel. I feed the camel, give it water, look after the camel. I do everything that is in my capacity to look after my camel. But my camel does not look after me. In the night it disturbs me. It does not let me sleep. Ye oont mujhe sone nahi deta. Aap sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ko dekhe. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, I have listened your part of the story. Now let me go and speak to the camel. سنے رحمت للعالمین سے سلیمان علیہ السلام کو اگر یہ معجزہ ملا, if he was given this miracle that he was multilingual, he could communicate with anyone, the jinns, the animals, subhanallah, this معجزہ was given to Prophet صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم even before Adam علیہ السلام's creation. ایسے جلیل القدر نبی تھے. سبحاناللہ, بی بی آمینہ کہتی ہے کہ جب ولادت ہوئی تو میں نے دیکھا کہ حضور علیہ السلام اپنی انگلیوں سے آسمانوں کی طرف اشارہ کر رہے. انگلی اس طرف جاتی ستارہ یوں جاتا, انگلی اس طرف جاتی ستارہ یوں جاتا. ہم نے دیکھا خدا کی قسم اب صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم کے اشارے پر ستارے چل رہے. یہ رحمت للعالمین صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم. I have listened to me, now let me listen to the camel. Aap sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to that person, go and call your camel. Aise jug jug kar wo ontni, that camel came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In the riwayat it comes that the first thing the camel did was it put the head down in front of Rasulullah as if it is doing salam to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Subhanallah to bole, subhanallah al-azim. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came with great love and affection. ہائے دنیا والے, تم ہمیں ٹیررسٹ کہتے ہو, میرے نبی نے تو جانوروں کے ساتھ بھی پیار کیا تھا. آپ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم نے اس اونٹ کو گلے سے لگایا. سبحان اللہ, خوش نصیب ہے وہ اونٹ. How lucky was that camel. حضور علیہ السلام stroked that camel. That camel touched the auspicious face of Rasulullah صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم. And حضور علیہ السلام said to that camel, now this master of yours, your owner, has filed a case against you. It has a complaint against you that you don't let your master, your owner, sleep in the night. According to him, he gives you everything, food and water. He does not lay on you. such burden that it becomes impossible for you to carry that load. He looks after you, gives you everything. And the camel looked at Huzur alayhi salam, dost aur buzrugo, wo camel, subhanallah, uski zaban ne Huzur alayhi salam ke saath guftagu kar rahi. And the camel spoke to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and says, O Messenger of Allah, everything what my master has said is the truth. What the owner has said is the truth. I have a good master, he is a good owner, he looks after me, he gives me food and water. But there is one evil act that is inside him, O Prophet of Allah, I want you to listen to me. Subhanallah al-Azim, dost aur buzrugo, aap ghaur se sunen. Allah ka khauf har ek ke andar hota hai. And the camel said to the Messenger of Allah, my master wakes up early in the morning, he prays his Fajr Salah, he comes back very, very tired. He performs his Maghrib Salah. He is so tired that after Maghrib he eats and he goes to sleep without praying Isha Salah. And when my master does not pray Isha Salah, it disturbs me that I am faithful to my master and he is not faithful to the master, to the creation of the subhanallah of the world. And that he has gone to sleep without performing Isha Salah. And so what I do is make noise and I scream and I want to disturb him. Possibly that by my noise, my master, my owner will wake up and Allah will give him the tawfiq. When he wakes up, he will perform his Isha Salah. O Prophet of Allah, I fear that because of him regularly missing his Isha Salah, Allah will punish him. And when Allah punishes him, I will also be punished. مجھے یہ خطرہ ہے کہ اللہ کی طرف سے عذاب آتا ہے تو عام عذاب آتا ہے یوں نہیں فلا آدمی بچ گیا نہیں عذاب عام آتا ہے. And if the punishment of Allah comes, it will strike him, he will be affected, I will be affected, out of fear that this person does not read Isha Salah, I make noise that he should wake up and he should read his Isha Salah. Abu sallallahu alayhi wa sallam again showed love and affection to this camel, stroked it and explained everything to that owner and said to him and warned him that this is your condition. Us bande ne tauba kiya Allah ke samne aur wo namaz ka paband ho gaya. My respected brothers, how many times will we hear the bayans and the taqreer and the advice, nasihat? Kitni martaba hum sunte? Until we don't change the condition of our heart, until the right dose of fear does not enter the heart, Subhanallah al-Azim, we are at the same level even after the month of Ramadan. We need to have the right dose of fear. Allah ka khawf. Once we have that, inshaAllah ta'ala, everything will be level. Dekhna, aadmi ko sugar ki bimari hoti hai, wo kitni mehnat karta hai. Khane mein, peene mein, sab kuch mehnat karta hai. Sugar ka level bilkul theek ho, tanasub ho. Iman ki bhi ye kaifiyat. If a person only fears, ye bhi galat hai. If a person only hopes, that is also wrong. It is fear and hope, the combination of fear and hope. And the right level of fear and the right level of hope, this is Iman. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us all the tawfiq. Wa akhiru da'wana. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.